This film is about the annual inspection of safety devices in conformity with EN 730. Once the safety functions and quality aspects have been outlined, the entire testing process with the IBEDA test device, PVGD, is explained. IBEDA flashback arrestors with multiple functions feature at least two and up to four safety functions. A gas non-return valve prevents the backflow of gas against flow direction. A flame arrestor will reliably prevent a flashback. A thermal cutoff valve protects against burnback by interrupting the gas supply if a critical temperature is exceeded. A pressure-sensitive cutoff valve interrupts the gas supply in the event of pressure surges. These occur, for example, during flashbacks. Each new IBEDA safety device is subjected to a 100% function test prior to distribution. As part of this inspection, the proper functioning of the gas non-return valve is checked. Leak tightness testing for this flashback arrestor is carried out by using maximum operating pressure. Flashback safety can only be checked using the testing facilities at the manufacturer's works. These were specially devised for this purpose, and flashback safety is guaranteed for the life cycle of the safety device. The laser-engraved consecutive serial number on each flashback arrestor ensures that each IBEDA safety device is clearly identifiable. It is not possible for a user to immediately ascertain the product quality of flashback arrestors. One can recognize a quality product and be assured that the safety device's functions conform to the established safety standards by a certificate issued through an external testing institute, for example, BAM or UL. Safety devices must be checked at regular intervals, at least, however, once a year. The inspection must be conducted by a trained and authorized person in accordance with country-specific regulations on flow rate, gas non-return, and leak tightness. These tests can be carried out with a PVGD test device. The PVGD is an easily handled testing unit designed to provide quick and uncomplicated testing of variously dimensioned flashback arrestors. IBEDA offers training for the annual checking of flashback detectors and autogenous equipment. Upon successful completion of such training, certificates of completeness are issued to participants. The test device, which comes with extensive accessories, can be put into operation with a few simple steps. The front panel's hand wheel is turned to closed. Now the testing medium can be connected. Be sure to use only oil-free compressed air or nitrogen. The inlet pressure must be between 4 and 7 bar. Subsequently, add distilled water to the funnel until the water level reaches the lower edge of the green mark. If the water level is too high, it can be lowered to the desired level by means of the drain screw. The gasket-equipped clamping tool, without the device under test, is pushed together and fixed into place with the locking and release lever. Now, turn the hand wheel from closed to gas flow. Via the throttle valve located at the top of the apparatus, one can adjust the gas flow in such a way that the bottom edge of the rotometer's float is level with mark 9 on the scale. By turning the hand wheel to the closed position, one completes the adjustment. The device is now operational. The test object is clamped in such a way that its flow direction corresponds to that of the test device. Flow measurement can begin by setting the hand wheel to gas flow. The boundary values for too little flow rate depend upon the particular device under test. Please consult the operating manual for this data. The data refers to the lower edge of the float. The device under test should indicate flow that is larger or equal to the boundary value. Prior to testing for gas non-return, set the hand wheel to the closed position. Without having to reposition the test object, the gas non-return valve can now be checked. To do this, set the hand wheel to reverse flow. If the float doesn't climb beyond the green mark within 30 seconds, the non-return valve is in good working order. Flashback arrestors with pressure-sensitive cutoff valves can also be checked. To do this, the test sample is clamped into place opposite the direction of flow. By turning the hand wheel to gas flow, the pressure-sensitive cutoff valve is released. If cutoff is not triggered, the safety device must be replaced. The leak tightness test that must be performed as part of the annual check may be conducted with a suitable leak detection spray. It has proven most effective to carry out the tightness test while putting the flashback arrestor back into operation. This way, one can check the reinstalled safety device as well as the connection points, which also need to be inspected. Set the pressure regulator to maximum allowable operating pressure for this particular workstation. Spray the connection points on the gas inlet and outlet side, and also spray the flashback arrestor. Should there be any leakage, it should be carefully determined what has caused this. Safety devices that don't pass this leakage test must be replaced. A flashback arrestor that has passed the test gets an inspection sticker indicating the next inspection date once it has been put back into service. Furthermore, the data for the service under test is also documented on the test block. This concludes the safety device annual inspection. IBEDA, Certified Safety.